Hello everyone, I hope you are all in good condition. Welcome to Meet Me Party Roseate at Pero's Cement Techno Channel. On this occasion I will explain about the preheater system, in the combustion process in a cement factory. In the process of burning raw flour into clinker, there are three processes, including is, 1. Preheating process in the preheater system. 2. Combustion process in the rotary kiln system. 3. Cooling process in the cooler system. The three processes mentioned above are interrelated and influence each other between one process and another. Because the discussion about the combustion process in the kiln system is very complex, and it takes a long time to discuss it, we will explain one by one. And on this occasion, we will explain about the type, function, and working principle of the preheater system. Please watch this video until the end, so you can understand about the preheater system in the kiln cement processing. Before I continue in this discussion, for those of you who have not subscribed, please subscribe first, so you can benefit from this video. Types of preheater system. There are several types of preheater systems, including, 1. Preheater without tertiary air duct. 2. Preheater with tertiary air duct or inline calciner. 3. Preheater with separate line tertiary air or separate line calciner. This is a sample image of a preheater without a tertiary air duct. Kiln cyclone preheater has several grades from 1 to 6 stages cyclone. The increase in fuel efficiency in the heating stage with the addition of the cyclone level is shown in figure 3.1.6. In general, the preheater is 4 stage cyclone, where the hot gases exit the preheater system at about 350 degrees Celsius. The material enters the rotary kiln already at about 800 degrees Celsius, and undergoes a decarbonization process of about 30%, some is calcined in the rotary kiln with some clinker reactions already initiated. Fuel consumption in 100% in the main burner kiln, so the service life of the refractory bricks in the kiln is shorter. The residence time of the feed material in the preheater is in the range of 30 seconds and in the kiln about 30 minutes. Kiln speed is usually 2 to 2.5 RPM. The pressure drop in the preheater system ranges from 400 mm H2O to 600 mm H2O, with gas velocity in the line usually 20 meters per second in the preheater and cyclone. The installed kiln capacity is up to 3,500 ton per day, with a specific fuel consumption of around 850 to 900 kilocalories per kilogram clinker. The larger kiln capacity is built with two preheater tower systems, keeping the cyclone size in proportion to the economy and efficiency required. The operation of the preheater system can be improved by adding several burners in the riser duct to increase the degree of calcination in the preheater. With the addition of a calciner burner in the riser duct, can increase the degree of calcination in the lowest cyclone up to 50% before the material enters to the kiln. The limit on how much fuel can be burned in the riser duct can be affected by the geometry of the duct, the design of the combustion system, or the type of fuel. However, ideally the quantity of fuel in the riser duct is limited to about 30% of the total fuel, due to the limited amount of excess air remaining from the kiln. Preheater and line calciner has kiln exhaust gases and tertiary air, making up the combustion air for the calciner, as shown in figure 3.1.7. While the separate line system has tertiary air only with 21% oxygen, forming the combustion air, as shown in figure 3.1.8. A separate line system, therefore, has a better combustion environment, and may be preferred for difficult fuels, such as alternative fuel. It has further advantage when converting preheater kiln to precalciners, in that there is minimal interference with the operating preheater kiln during the construction phase for the new separate line preheater tower and tertiary air duct. In the precalciner system, air for fuel combustion in the calciner chamber is drawn from the cooler through the tertiary air duct. In general, 60% to 65% of the total fuel is burned in the calciner, and the raw meal is calcined more than 90% before entering to the rotary kiln. The precalciner kiln has a very large output, exceeding 10,000 tons per day, with a specific heat consumption of less than 700 kilocalories per kilogram clinker. There are several different configurations, preheater systems operating with one or two calciner chambers, in both inline calciner configurations and separate line calciner configurations. Preheater with separate line calciner. This type of precalciner system can only operate in conjunction with the great cooler, because there is no way to take the tertiary air out of the planetary cooler. The precalciner has a larger and longer combustion chamber, allowing it to use more fuel. The use of fuel in the calciner is 65 to 70%, and in the main burner kiln 30 to 35%, so that the life of the fire bricks in the kiln is more durable. This is an example of a precalciner system configuration with a combination of ILC and SLC. This type of preheater system has two tertiary air ducts from the cooler system. The diameter of the ILC tertiary air duct is smaller than the tertiary air duct for SLC. The fuel combustion process in the SLC burner only relies on air from the cooler, and for the ILC burner it takes the remaining combustion air from the kiln and some of the cooler. This is one example preheater system combination of ILC and SLC with 5 cyclone levels. The installed capacity is 7,500 tons of clinker per day. Fuel consumption in the ILC burner is around 10%. Fuel consumption in the SLC burner is around 55%. And fuel consumption in the main burner kiln is around 35%. The degree of calcination coming out of the lowest cyclone SLC equals 90 to 96%. Calciner burner is equipment for burning fuel in the preheater system, which functions to increase the temperature in the calciner chamber and increase the degree of calcination. The calciner burner is installed in the riser duct or in the calciner chamber, where the burner still receives sufficient air or O2 to burn the fuel. For Calciner-ILC, the combustion air is taken from the cooler through the tertiary air duct, and the remaining combustion air from the kiln, while for SLC the combustion air is only taken from the cooler through the tertiary air duct. The function of the preheater system is to preheat the raw flour, which is fed through the top cyclone to the bottom cyclone and undergoes several processes, including the process of evaporation of the water content of the feeding material at a temperature greater than 100 degrees Celsius that occurs in the top cyclone. Separation process, or separation between material and hot gas, that occurs in each cyclone preheater. The process of heat transfer from the hot gas to the material, which occurs along the hot gas line and inside the cyclone. Decarbonation process is the process of decomposition of carbon CaCO3 to CaO plus CO2, which occurs from a temperature of 700 to 900 degrees Celsius. That was the explanation about preheater and calciner in general, and in the next video we will explain about the supporting components in the preheater system. Thank you for watching this video, see you in the next video.